We are back, of course, with Dateline Atlantic City with a couple pretty good pals. In fact, three great pals of Jerry, too. We're speaking about Steve Allen, Jayne Meadows, and Frankie Randall, all good pals of Jerry Vale. In fact, Jerry, you're part of that that close-knit community.
Oh, absolutely.
Right?
He doesn't do as much knitting as he used to, but he's still very close to
it. He's one of our pals.
Does he purl or does he just knit? That's what I want to know.
He does Jack Pearl, which is funny only to three living people who remember who Jack Pearl was.
Jerry did one of Steve's songs in the movie Goodfellas. What was it called?
Yes, it was a little of his of mine that he recorded from the 50s called Pretend You Don't See Her, My Heart.
That's right.
In fact, it's the only song they performed in that movie, which is nice of them. Mm-hmm. Thank you again, Mr. Scorsese, if you're watching.
Yeah, and what was in that motion picture, in that film, in that flick, that was Jerry still speaks about that all the time. But that song, it kind of blended, it fit into the whole component of that picture for
right.
some reason. The sound of Jerry singing, I can't explain it, folks, don't worry about it. Let's say that we are back, of course, Sonny Schwartz, Dateline, Atlantic City, we come your way. Monday through Friday, 9 to 11 p.m., or in that area, you know, neighborhood, in that neighborhood. And then again on weekends with the morning, afternoon, and evening editions of Dateline Atlantic City. Always sending out our little entertainment variety review with Oceans of Love, or perhaps tonight with the full moon, Tidal Waves of Love from the gaming capital of the world, the entertainment capital of the East, the boxing capital of the East, the world's famous playground once again, and the city that not only never sleeps, it doesn't even take a nap, Atlantic City, New Jersey.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Every time I say that, Steve does nod off. He does nod off.
Snoring shtick.
Okay. But Steve, wide awake right now. And, of course, tonight, as always, broadcasting on the 15-state Happy Talk Network, Media One Radio Entertainment Network, MORE, as it's called, which gets us all around this country and 43 countries around the world, and Suburban TV, TCI of North Jersey,
right.
Shore Cable Company of New Jersey. What else? What am I missing? OBC. Oh, how can I forget OBC up in North and Central Jersey? Everybody loves Steve Allen. They love Jayne Meadows. Everybody loves anyway, but especially up in that area. And Frankie Randall, he used to perform up there. In fact, he's from that area, aren't you?
I'm from Clifton, New Jersey.
That's right. That's right. That's where he's from. Well, I'm saying that's right. You should know. Frankie.
That is right.
That is right. I know.
I love being on in 15 countries. Hello, Ecuador.
43.
Como esta?
43, Steve.
Who counts?
Not when you're having fun. Okay, tonight.
I know you're on 43, but I only love being on 15 of them. I'm very particular.
Okay, Steve Allen
getting
with us.
Screams in Colombia means nothing to me right now.
Steve Allen, we have to do something. As you know on this show, Janie knows it too. Frankie, maybe he doesn't know it, but you have done Happy Talk with Sonny many times.
I'm happy to talk to anybody, Sonny.
Okay.
Why would I rule you out at a time like
and this? Right now. Right now, we're going to say that it's Happy Talk time on Dateline Atlantic City, so let's do the thing.
Talk about things you'd like to do.
Oh, yeah, Happy Talk, and right now, let's bring them back, of course, as they accompany... I can't say that word. Accompany. Jayne, can you say...
Accompanying? Which word?
Accompanying.
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 It's a tough word to
it
say,
It is
Sonny.
Tough. It's difficult.
Accompanying. The five
accompanying.
Syllables.
Accompanying.
Quite a tune about that,
yeah.
Steve. Yeah.
But you are... What do you mean? Another one? He's 4,300 tunes. We're counting. He dashed off seven in the rolling chair coming over here. I know
right,
that.
Right.
Okay. How about that for a title? Rolling Chair Blues.
Believe it or not, I recently did write a song because I have been suffering from sciatica. I wrote a song called Wheelchairs, Crutches, and Canes, a waltz. Wheelchairs, crutches, and canes.
I like the beat. I like the beat. Okay, Steve Allen, what was I saying? Does anybody remember? Does anybody care? I was saying that I was interrupted again.
Accompanying.
Oh, that's
accompanying.
What I was saying.
Yes,
Jayne Meadows, you've been acting. You've been acting. You know how to pronounce everything. You've done dialects. You've done role. You did Lost in Yonkers. Give me that dialect.
I just, I have to tell you something. When I stop doing a dialect, I have to then spend a few hours to get back into it. I have done, my German accent for Lost in Yonkers was I was told by people who do accents and by real Germans, absolutely authentic. But as I told you,
as opposed to false Germans. I mean, now Steve would have said that. See, but he, go ahead.
But honestly, I worked on it. I think you and I talked on the telephone when I was working on it.
That's right.
For at least 6 months.
And you went out and you researched it. I remember this because we spoke extensively about this. You went out and followed certain people around.
Strangers. Strangers. I was in New York City.
That's the truth.
Yes,
anybody
I was.
With an accent, you wouldn't follow them. Right?
I did. I was in New York City and I was just shopping and I heard about three people with German accents in front of me, and I ran up to them and I said, "Excuse me, would you mind saying these words for me?" Now they looked at me like
what
I
words?
Was loony bin, whatever words I was working on.
Oh,
for
you mean
my
on
role.
A script, otherwise.
Yes, and I explained to them I'm an American actress, and I'm. And they kept, you know how people are when they know you're crazy and they're trying to get away from you. And I said, "These are very difficult words for me. Would you help me with this word?"
One word was sauerkraut. How tough could it be?
No, they were rather difficult. They were the sweetest people. They stood right in the middle of Fifth Avenue and helped me. They were real Germans who had just gotten off the airplane from mm-hmm. Germany. And that's what I would do. Then, of course, I practiced.
You thought you were holding them up. That's
yes,
why
I'm sure they thought I was going to stab them or something. Crazy.
What's happening for me?
Accompanying. Accompanying.
Okay, so I'm going to be, once again, as always, accompanied by the winningest string band, Mummers Day history. That's what they are, the award-winning Furco string band, as they do every night. And I'll tell you something else, folks. Their captain, Bill Spezial, was with us the other night, and he said, "Sonny, next time we come down, we're going to bring all 340. But tonight, just a little contingent, as always, as we say that, indeed, happy days are here once again.
Happy days are here again.
Okay, we are ready with Frankie and Stevie and Janie and Sonny. Here we go, everybody, along our networks, video and radio as well. Join in with us as we say, every day. You know what to do.
No.
Jane, you've done it with me before. Steve
did
it. You know what? I'll tell you something. Steve was here solo last time, he did this, and he had us rolling around on the boardwalk.
Nobody was laughing.
Out of the studio. Oh, no, he's going to do it. Okay, right. You have to repeat after Sonny.
Okay.
Every day. In every way.
I'm getting better.
And better. I'm going to keep the faith. No cloudy thoughts. Only sunny thoughts. So help me, Sonny. It's supposed to be
Sunny.
But you said something witty last time. You're clever. Can't you remember what you said? I don't remember.
No, I don't remember. I don't even have an act. That's why I do a new show every time. I can't remember anything.
So help me, Sonny. All right, now everybody take a deep breath. Let it out.
Oh, I don't want to let it out.
Okay. And say,
I feel great.
Great.
Well, I'll tell you something. The Fontan sisters, they're not. Okay, I'll tell you something. Not the McGuire's either.
Frank Fontaine, we are.
We do better with the non-pros doing that. Yeah, that's
well,
right. Not Charlie pros, but the non-pros.
Maybe if we did it again and fast right with you.
Please.
And
okay.
What tune can we do it to?
We do it. The bed. That's
no
called
tune.
A bed. Musical bed. That's playing. Happy Days is here again.
Oh,
plays.
See.
The viewers and the listeners hear that.
Oh.
Okay. So that's
marching around. They're marching around the breakfast table.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Right, with Don McNeil.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Right now, let's do it once again for Jane. Can we get the Furcos back in a couple seconds? You mean they're tuning up once again? In the meantime, how about Jane? If you sing Happy Days Are Here again, it's one of your favorite songs.
Well,
can we hear it with the track?
Sure.
Oh, they're waiting for it.
Oh, yeah. See, they have to warm up.
Happy days are here again. They're something skies.
Why are days so happy for you
as
right now,
just
Jane?
Called.
Well,
that's
I'll tell you.
Let's talk about it.
I have never had a day that wasn't really happy in my whole life, Sonny, and I'm not exaggerating.
I'll see you tomorrow.
My mother, who was my best friend, died, but I knew...
I'm sorry.
No,
laugh
don't laugh, because I knew that her passing was... God willed it, mm-hmm. and then along came grandchildren, and we just had a beautiful little granddaughter born, 3 weeks ago now, and she was premature. They're all premature, and sometimes they have problems, but boy, they're there. We're all here, And why would we not be happy?
Why don't you tell everybody how many grandchildren you have?
12? Or is it 10?
Yes, you Frankie.
I think it's
12. Boy, are we happy. They didn't live to see their 6-month birthday.
I think it's 10, and I'm just hoping 12 soon. But no,
old-timers
I'm always
disease,
happy.
Folks.
I'm always happy.
Is the Furco String Band happy? They are?
Yeah, good.
Okay, then right now let's say that indeed, happy days are here once again.
Happy days are here again.
Okay, now everybody repeat it after Sonny. Every day.
Every day.
In every way. I'm getting better. And better. Oh, gosh. Oh, gee. Where's Alfred Hitchcock when I need him? I'm going to keep the faith.
I'm going to keep the faith.
No cloudy thoughts.
No cloudy thoughts.
Only sunny thoughts. So help me, Sonny. Okay, now you all take a deep breath. Okay. Exhale and say, I feel great. Now they sound like something. Okay, not bad. And you know you're going to not just do great, you're going to feel great when you do Happy Talk with Sonny and Jayne and Steve and Frankie. No question about it.
You know, funny thing, people often, performers always say in quotation marks, thank you, ladies and germs. This studio is so small that the audience only has one germ. How do you like that? But seriously, folks.
Now, here's what we say, though. We say when we do Happy Talk, of course, we joke around, we kid around with it. We've done it with just about everybody. Mm-hmm. But there is a serious message that we impart as well. When we say serious, we want the folks to stay happy and stay positive in life. You know, you hear of positive thinking, you hear of positive speaking, mm-hmm. but we want you to be a positive being because that's what makes it for you. And by all means, if you have that attitude, in the vernacular, if you have that attitude, you will improve not only your life, but the lives of those around you. So at all times, remember to keep your sunny side up. And that's our Happy Talk message tonight with the accompaniment of our three dear friends.
Hear no evil, see no evil, and how's your sister?
And Frankie.
And you know what I think is interesting about that song?
What is that, Jayne?
That song became popular during the Depression. Mm-hmm. Which was a very serious time in this country.
Yeah,
I'm very popular during my depression.
And we don't have a depression now in our country.
I'll see you Tuesday.
So you see how psychologically it helped get us out of that depression.
I sure do. Mm-hmm. Now, speaking about getting out of any kind of anything, you have to tell me, Jayne, because I'm going to get to Steve, what you have been up to lately, because you just did an infomercial that knocks me out just talking about it, speaking about it.
It's hilarious.
It is hilarious.
I did it. It was, I know him so well, Henny Youngman's 80th birthday party. And the Friar.
He's 80 and your memory is slipping?
I know.
Should be
it's
the
terrible.
Other way around.
I think he's older than 80. I think he's older. I'm serious because he's on our show quite a bit. I think he's older.
His act is older, but I think he's only 80.
The infomercial is the best infomercial that I've ever seen in my life because you're not aware that it's an infomercial. You think it's the Friars doing a roast. Mm-hmm. And it was a roast, and when they asked me, I said, me? I've never done a roast in my life. What am I going to do? They said, just be there. Just show up. So I had this gorgeous dress, and I thought, well, I'll smile a lot or whatever. They sat me right next to Henny. I was in the middle of everything. Now, they had on Fred Travellina, Freddie Roman, Red Buttons, Steve, Jan Murray. Who are the others? The one that does the funny words.
Crosby.
I can't remember all the people. Now, all these comedians.
And Jayne Meadows.
And me. And, oh, no, they had that marvelous Marilyn Michaels.
Oh, yeah.
You know, she's brilliant.
Yeah,
but I wrote my own first joke, and they looked at me like, well, I think maybe, sweetheart, maybe not. You know, it's kind of not right for a roast. Well, it was one of the
biggest.
It was one of the biggest laughs. Now, if I tell it now, it sounds terrible, but I think it was a big laugh because they thought, what gall she has, beautiful dress or not, to get
it's
up
right.
here with all these guys?
All gold is divided into three parts. But what was the joke?
I just got up.
Can we save that for the funny of the night? We do a funny of the night, Dink.
Funny of the night?
Yeah, we do a funny of the night.
Funny of the night?
Oh, so I don't tell it now? Well, maybe it isn't so funny now.
Okay, tell it now.
Tell it now.
Because it was funny that night.
Then Frankie will do the
funny
of the
night. And it was an enormous audience, a big ballroom.
Yeah, there were only 12 people, but they were very big.
But I got up and I said, thank you very much. And I'm very, very, you know, nervous about being here with all these brilliantly funny people on the dais. And I said, as a matter of fact, Red, when you asked me if I would be part of, if I would take part in this roast tonight for Henny Youngman, I thought you meant to cook it. Well, it was a scream. Now, you know that's not very funny. It's so amateurish and sort of sweet little.
But so sincere.
But it's
but
cute.
It was cute and it was.
Right at that time.
Perfect for me.
And you wrote it yourself.
I wrote it myself.
Steve Allen.
And cooked it herself. Yeah. And ate it herself.
They laughed.
Well, that's great.
We just laughed again.
Yeah. Now, wait, is that on the infomercial, by the way?
It's on the infomercial.
Well, I can't wait to see it again.
They had to cut because, you know, those comedians, they never shut up. They went on and on and on and on and on. And everybody had 2 minutes. But they kept my little dumb joke in. I was so glad.
No question about it. Okay.
It's a marvelous infomercial.
Okay. Right now, what we're going to do is remind all of our listeners and viewers tonight that Steve Allen is appearing at Trump Plaza and the acclaimed In Concert series. And Steve, how many months ago were you here with us?
Several months. I'm not sure. I don't keep track of anything.
I was thinking it was seven, six.
Yeah. All right.
I don't know. But I don't know. I stopped counting. But it really, this is truly unprecedented since the In Concert series started to bring somebody back this rapidly. And you have to feel justifiably proud of that because it is a kind of precedent setting. Yes, they have many people come back and perform, but usually it's about a year. But Steve was brought back by popular insistence. And the show tomorrow night, you're wrapping it up, right?
Yep.
Yes.
Tomorrow night is the final show, and the show time is what?
Tomorrow's Thursday?
7:30. Thursday. Okay, so it will be the last opportunity to catch Steve, along with Mr. Randall, Frankie Randall, also in the spotlight. And Jayne Meadows, she'll be there. She enjoys the show, absolutely.
Every night.
Every single night she is there. And you'll see her. She's the young lady who looks fantastic, very charming, very, very charming, very attractive. And she writes her own jokes, by the way. Yeah, she does. Yeah. So you'll recognize her.
Aww.
And, you know, before we were speaking about a song that was in Goodfellas, and Jerry Vail sang that song. Jerry Vail's a friend of all of us, really.
Of long standing.
Yeah, of long standing. And at this time, it would be not only fitting, but apropos and appropriate as well to, can I stretch that a little longer? No. Appropriate as well. And also the right thing to do to hear.
So very enjoyable for everybody.
It would be that. It would be that as well. And Frankie, any other words that we could say about it? Fitting, proper. Oh, proper. We didn't say proper.
We didn't say proper, and we didn't tell the folks how Jerry Vail plays golf. I played golf with him about 2 days before I came here. He's a god-awful golfer.
But he's going to get the report on this.
He plays well. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Right now, what's his handicap?
I don't know.
No talent?
It's the sweater he wears.
Yeah.
It has no sleeves.
His gloves.
Okay. Right now, what we're going to do is listen to a gentleman by the name of Gennaro Vitaliano. No, what's his?
Valente.
Vitaliano? I was right. How can I be right? You should know Anthony DeFlorio, number three. Okay, you got that right. Gennaro Vitaliano, our dear friend, and singing the Steve Allen composition from the motion picture Goodfellas, and sold about 17 million before that. Jerry Vail's version of Pretend You Don't See Her. What a beautiful song. Magnifico.
Look somewhere above her, pretend you don't love her, pretend you don't see her at all. Pretend you don't see her, my heart, although she our way. Pretend you don't need her, my heart, but smile and pretend to to be gay. It's too late for running my heart. Chin up if the tears start to fall. Look somewhere above her. Pretend you don't love her. Pretend you don't see her.
Silky smooth sound of Jerry Vale singing Pretend You Don't See Her. And that song is just beautiful. That's all you can say about it. I don't think any other description is needed other than it's a beautiful tune, beautiful lyrics, and certainly a beautiful guy singing the song. Anything that you can tell us, Steve, about that song? Or
yes, I'll tell you what comes to my mind, Sonny, and it's a serious recollection. Back in the days when Jerry had that hit record, the late 50s, Vic Damone was our guest on our old Sunday night show one night, and as his personal bad luck would have it, he had just broken up with Pier Angeli, the very lovely lady to whom, were they married? I can't remember.
Yeah.
Anyway, it was suddenly all over. The very week he was scheduled to appear on our show, and he had already decided himself, he'd heard Jerry's record, he wanted to do the number, and he did. And what I'm about to describe was not planned. It couldn't be. Nobody's that great an actor. Vic's always been a very pleasant fellow to look at, so our director, Dwight Hemian, slowly, as he did the song, moved into a very tight close-up of his face, and about the ninth bar, a single tear rolled down his face. He suddenly realized what he was singing, and he identified with it, as we say. Hmm. It's one of the most emotional moments in the history of television.
Really? As you say, you could see it was genuine.
Yeah.
It was for sure. That is some moment. Has that been captured? I know a lot of your a lot of the shows have been captured, and some have been lost. Well, not captured. We shouldn't say that because possibly if they were, we'd all be in trouble. But many of them have been saved over the years. But was that? Do you recall whether that was ever?
Yeah, we have that show
reserved for posterity.
As a matter of fact, about 2 years ago, our son Bill Allen, who's the president of MTM Television, took the comedy portions of those old Sunday night shows, the ones with Louie Nye and Don Knotts and that great gang of guys, and set the music over to one side. We didn't discard it. It's all still on the shelves. But turned it into a totally comedy series, and it's been carried for the last 2 years on the Comedy Central Network.
Yeah.
It's all over the world.
It's terrific.
Everywhere.
I know that, and that's terrific.
Some of the very countries we're talking to right now.
That's true. Ecuador as well.
Yes.
Right now, Anthony, you were telling me our TV and producer, but also more than our TV guy, also our music historian. And you told me that we had a clip we were almost going to show tonight of Steve Allen, a TV clip of Steve Allen with Al Jolson. Was that
radio?
Old radio.
Yes.
You with Al Jolson.
That was one of the most exciting
First live interview with Al Jolson.
One of the most exciting nights of my life. Just as a fan, I was just standing by while he glowed like the sun. I was doing a late night show in Hollywood before we all got into the thing called television, although it was much the same kind of show. I'd go out in the audience and do the same kind of nonsense. And we had one guest per night. And this particular night, it was Jolson. it was a big comeback time for him because it was after the movie of his life had come out with Larry Parks, and suddenly after having been out of the business for a good many years, he was suddenly not only back in the business, but number one. And my age was, I'm now 72, but even then I'm too young to have seen Jolson in his prime, which was the 20s. All I see is old film clips, which you can see today. Anyway, he came into the studio and he turned on the charm and that magnificent warmth and that kind of likable conceit for which he was known. He brought in his own piano player, and I just stood by and kept turning him on. I just laughed and smiled and applauded. It's one of the greatest one-hour shows in the history of entertainment. He did about six tunes, one over the audience.
No, we do have it, but right now we have to break for the network, and that's what we're going to do right now. So we're going to come back and not only complete that story, but a lot more happening, is including a lot of great music right here on Dateline. But we have to get out of here this second with part two. We'll be right back. I'm Sonny. This is Dateline Atlantic City.